Good morning. Welcome to Cape Town vlog day 2. We landed in Cape Town yesterday and I woke up feeling rested, ready and excited to explore the city. This morning, we were greeted by cloudy skies and a light morning drizzle, adding a touch of unpredictability to our plans. Despite having a set itinerary of activities including going to the beach, we decided to embrace the ever-changing weather and let that guide our day. It became apparent that Cape Town weather can be quite unpredictable, a realization that initially left me feeling frustrated, especially considering my lack of warm clothes. Because of this gloomy weather, we decided to go on a hike. We initially wanted to hike on Lion's Head, but decided to take a stroll at Kirstenbosch National Botanical Garden instead. For breakfast today, we are having Ever Toast on sourdough bread with freshly cut fruits with some yogurt and a warm cup of rooibos tea to warm us up on the inside. By the way, I forgot to introduce myself. My name is Kat. If you're new to my channel, welcome or welcome back. If you're a returning subscriber, I hope you're well. I'm really excited for this Cape Town trip because it's my first time in Cape Town and I just want to share the experience with you. If you haven't seen our landing video, I'll leave that on the description box and don't forget to subscribe. If you're wondering about our mode of transport today, we used an Uber to get to Kirstenbosch National Garden. The trip was a little bit on the rough side in terms of the drive. It wasn't like a secure, I didn't feel safe, basically. I did not feel safe. But it was really lovely to see Cape Town regardless. So Kirstenbosch is nestled against the eastern slopes of Table Mountain, showcasing a variety of unique plant species, including fynbos, protea and cycas within carefully curated gardens and natural landscapes. It spans over 500 hectares, which is like 5 rugby fields. That's pretty large, making it the largest botanical garden in Africa. That's a really cool fact. Beyond its role as a picturesque tourist destination, Kirstenbosch plays a vital role in conservation and research efforts. It serves as a living laboratory for studying native plants, species, and their ecosystems, contributing to an ongoing effort to preserve South Africa's unique biodiversity. We also saw the fun Rebex hedge. That was my first time seeing a tree that grows this unique. It was really fascinating. We also walked down the tree canopy. I've always seen this on Instagram, to be honest. I didn't know that it was here, so this was a lovely surprise. I was very curious to see the entire view of the city from the highest point of the garden, and we walked up a flight of stairs and I wasn't really satisfied with what I saw, so I just decided for us to continue walking up those flight of stairs, unknowingly that we're actually embarking on what felt like a 4.5 kilometers worth of a hike. Before you know it, we were like deep in the mountains and we were contemplating either going back or just going forward, and it was really fun being up there even though we weren't mentally prepared for a hike, because that's not what we were trying to do. I think the reason we didn't want to go for a hike is because we didn't want to feel like dead tired. But anyway, we're in the mountain, we saw the views like I wanted, and then we had to now hike down. I really felt the effect of the gravity on my knees. It was like I was an old woman. It was so crazy. For lunch, we decided to go old school and packed a lunchbox. How cute. So we went to Woolworths and had a look at these sandwiches and decided on getting this corned beef and mustard sandwich, which slapped. Till this day, this has been the best sandwich I've bought from a shop. I'm not really a big fan of buying sandwiches at a shop. I prefer making my own, but this one was really delicious. I also bought this snack bar, almond, mango and apricot granola bar, one of my favorites, and we just had like a sit down picnic on one of the benches. We actually wanted to sit down by that pond that we saw earlier on, but it was already taken, like how all good spots are taken. But my experience here at Kirstenbosch was really amazing. Like, if I could camp there and sleep there for the night, I would, because I'm an outdoor kind of girl and this was definitely one for the books. Really loved it.
I can honestly get used to the views here in Cape Town. They are so breathtaking. I've never really seen anything like it, if I have to be honest with my own eyes. I only ever see these kind of views on TV. We are currently getting ready to go out for dinner. We are going out for dinner. My outfit is jean, a belt, a white polo shirt, and my knitwear, because Cape Town weather so far has been unpredictable. It's quite warm, but I always need to be safe because I don't know how long we're going to be out for. I think I'm going to wear sandals. I've been in sneakers the whole day. Yep. Good morning and welcome to this mini series, Traveling with the Masondos, Cape Town Vlog 3. I hope you guys are still enjoying it. I know I am. Today is a beautiful sunny morning. I hope that the weather stays like this. After checking the weather app, it said that it would be sunny the whole day. Since I've been to Cape Town, the weather has been more on the gloomy side and cold. Today I'm wearing a long sleeve shirt just to be on the safe side. On today's itinerary, we're going to be on the red bus, which I think is going to be so much fun because I'm going to see the whole of Cape Town. I've just been on Sea Point, and yesterday we went to Kirstenbosch, so I want to just see the whole of Cape Town. We haven't been to the beach yet. We've just walked past Saunders and Queen's Beach, but we haven't been to like Clifton or Camps Bay, which is like where I want to see and where I want to be tomorrow. But for today, we're going to be on the red bus. It's going to be so much fun. Yesterday when we went to Kirstenbosch, we packed a sandwich lunch box that we bought from Woolworths and also bought some snack bars, and it was such a good way of like having lunch on the go. So I think we're going to use a similar blueprint for today, buying lunch like as a caffeine, and then we're gonna have dinner like later on at a restaurant or somewhere. So right now I'm going to be making breakfast. I'm going to be making a avocado toast on sourdough bread and yogurt with some fresh fruit.
Thank you.
We requested an Uber to the V&A waterfront where we would be starting our red bus tour, and our Uber driver this morning, Akuru Mlungu, guys, it was so surprising for me because I had never been driven in Mlungu in an Uber before. It was very delightful. It was very chatty, quite the experience, only in Cape Town. And then we get to the V&A waterfront and this place looks picturesque, it's scenic, the historic buildings, the vibe, just being there felt really good. It looks like the pictures online, but then it just feels better being there. We went to H&M to get hubs, some sunglasses, because Diambarele Cape Town, Ratlunya, guys. And then after we went to go and hop on to our bus. So we ordered our bus tickets online that same morning. And luckily for us, there was a special, so we got to save some money for food, baby. This bus is called Hop On, Hop Off City Sightseeing Cape Town. What a mouthful. This bus is giving tourist energy and I'm here for it. I highly recommend this bus, especially if you want to see all the places that you wouldn't necessarily go to because there's so little time and so much to do and you can't be everywhere all at once, all at the same time, right? I really enjoyed this bus tour. It's so comprehensive. You really get to see Cape Town. And my biggest observation on this tour was that Cape Town is very clean, it's very beautiful, and I really just love the historic and old architecture. Like, it was breathtaking. Like, the combination of like the greenery, the architecture, it being clean, just the energy, just everything. This tour, it's giving tourists, and I'm here for it. We bought a 2-day premium combo, and what that basically means, as complicated as that already sounds, is that we can hop on and off on this bus for 2 days wherever that there's a bus stop. If we had known about this option yesterday, we would have taken the red bus to Kirstenbosch for our hike and then also had the benefit of an extra tour. This ticket also included a canal cruise that we did not use because there was so much to do. We were so overwhelmed and just little time, and it not being a priority because we had an itinerary full of things to do. This tour, like I said, was very comprehensive and I highly recommend it because you really get to see Cape Town and all its beauty. We drove through Cape Town CBD where I got to observe of how clean Cape Town is. I got to see Long Street that I heard so much about, and we also got to see Kirstenbosch for the second time and parked at Constantia Neck where there's the wine bus tour. We did not do the wine bus tour because it's not something that we're into. We're not wine people, if I can put it like that. And then we also drove down a township called Imizamuye too. It was really nice seeing a township in Cape Town and just how, you know, there are two different parts of like the world. There's just the bougie side and then clean cut line, there's a township. I also got to see Hout Bay, a peak of the Atlantic Ocean and the blue horizon. And my favorite part, you may ask, Chapman's Peak Drive. It's absolutely breathtaking, and the panoramic scenery is stuff from the movies, literally. This road stretches along the Atlantic coast for about 8 kilometers from Sea Point to Hout Bay. This was the most breathtaking thing I had ever seen in my life. Like, I wanted to pinch myself. I also got to see the 12 apostles and got to see Camps Bay and Clifton 2, all the different beaches, and I was just spot checking of like the different beaches that we could go to. Like, it was overwhelming how much I saw on that tour, and because of that, I highly recommend it. Back at the V&A waterfront, we decided to have lunch at this cafe called Native Coffee Roasters. After walking around trying to decide where we want to eat and also just assessing our appetite, if we are really hungry or if we just want to have something light, and today we decided to have something light. And this food was really good. It actually made me think that I should buy salmon more often so I can make these little cute sandwiches at home. I never buy salmon for some reason. I always make eggs and just other things and not really salmon. Maybe it's because it's expensive, but I really think that I should make these things myself at home so that when I go out, I'm not like shook. But anyway, we went home, took a little nap because it was really exhausting sitting in the bus. Sometimes it was windy, sometimes it was still hot. It was a really long trip. I've seen a lot and I just need to have a little bit of energy for our sunset drive because it's something that we're also going to do later on. So then we went to Spar to get some milk tart and some nibbles for our Signal Hill picnic, and we also ordered some KFC for some extra like meat and extra nibbles. I really enjoyed the sunset trip. I did change into something warm because I didn't want to be uncomfortable, but this was really my favorite part of like the tour. Like, if you thought that the one in the afternoon was great, like this one was even better. I want to take my evening bath. It's going to actually be the third bath that I take for the day. And before you judge me, just hear me out. I'm feeling very cold right now because we just came back from our bus sunset tour and the Cape Town wind is so crazy. I'm feeling really cold, and while the water cools down because I poured a lot of hot water, I just wanted to tell you guys about my day and how it's been. It's been honestly a beautiful day. I'm honestly so overwhelmed about everything that I've seen here in Cape Town. It's been a lot. Like, my mind can't even comprehend everything that I've seen. Like, it was just a lot. I honestly underestimated the red bus tour. I thought today was just going to be like a boring trip around, but honestly it was so much to take in on how beautiful Cape Town is and how clean it is and how much I've learned. Yeah, there's just been a lot going on. So we woke up early, we had breakfast, we had the avocado and sourdough with fresh fruits and yogurt, and thereafter we took an Uber to the VA waterfront between like 7:30 to 8, and because my husband is the one who requested the Uber, I'm always like on the lookout to like look for the car, and there's always that awkward moment when the Uber says it's arrived and you're looking for the car and he's also like parked in the wrong side of the road, and then you just like trying to confirm if that's the car. And I would drive on the road, I was a bit confused because I saw the car, I saw the plate number, and then when I looked up at the driver, I was like, is that the right person? It was so weird that I would drive on the road, guys. That was so funny, but he was such a cool driver. He was busy asking us if we're from Joburg. He was just busy going on about Cape Town and how beautiful it is, and
how much we should have a good time. It was such a good driver. It was such a cool experience. When we got to the VA waterfront, we got our tickets for the bus. We actually got tickets for 2 days. We can hop on and hop off the bus, and thereafter we went to H&M at the shopping center to get my husband some sunglasses, because after our walk yesterday at the beach we realized that deambula tlunya, we needed to get him sunglasses. I already had sunglasses, which was great. And then we went back to the bus. We waited for about 10 minutes before the bus departed, and I honestly thought it was going to be very boring, but I saw a lot of Cape Town in today's trip. I highly recommend, if you're in Cape Town, take the red bus so you can have like a comprehensive experience of all the places than just to be at one location. So the bus started at the VA waterfront, and then it drove into Cape Town CBD, which I can honestly say that it's way better than Joburg. It's so clean, it's so beautiful. I think that they sweep Cape Town at night when you're sleeping, because the way Cape Town is so clean, like it just blows my mind, because Joburg is so dirty. I'm really surprised at how clean Cape Town is. You'd swear like they clean it at night, and there's always those places where you suspect that like it's dirty, but like no, it's always so clean. And I got to see part of Long Street, and thereafter we drove towards like Kirsten Bosch side, and we actually stopped at the Kirsten Bosch, and some people got out, some people came in the bus, and then we went to some Bird Sanctuary place, because there are like multiple different stops along the way. And then thereafter we went past Constantia and this place called Imizamoyetu. It's like a rural area, and thereafter it's like Hout Bay, which we're gonna go to tomorrow. It looks very interesting. And then the bus turned back, coming back to like Camps Bay, and we took this really gorgeous scenic drive down the ocean. Like that part like blew my mind. Like honestly, we thought me seeing the beach yesterday blew my mind. Like the scenic drive to me was like something else. It drove down like Camps Bay, Clifton, 4321, and then back to Sea Point, where I had already like familiarized myself with like some parts of the area, so I kind of saw like, oh, this is how this place connects. Like it was really interesting. And then thereafter a little bit of like this Green Point, and then we got to the VA waterfront again, and then we got to the VA waterfront. We thought maybe we should have lunch there, so we walked around, looked for some restaurants, and then we ended up going to this place called Ginger. But then inside of Ginger, they've got like a native coffee place. That's where we decided to eat. I wasn't like starving, I just wanted to have like something to eat so I don't like faint. So we had a sandwich. I ordered like a bagel with salmon, which was so fresh. And then he ordered like a little bun with some chicken. The bun roll thing was called ngugu, which I think is funny because ngugu means chicken in Zulu. Really fun way of playing with words. And then we Ubered back to our place because we were so tired. I needed like a break, also just to charge our phones, took a nap, refreshed. And then we walked down the road to catch another red bus, to now go back to the waterfront to catch the sunset bus that will take us to Signal Hill and drive like a different route from what we've driven earlier on. And it was like a nice sunset drive. We got to Signal Hill, saw the sunset, and it was beautiful. It was beautiful. We were there for about what felt like an hour. The bus like waited there, and once we were done, it started blowing like this crazy wind. Like one thing about Cape Town, like that, it's so unpredictable, it's annoying. Luckily for me, I went with like my net underwear and a towel. Even in the morning, actually, I had a towel when we were like driving, because that wind, it can literally just blow your ears off with how crazy it is. So after chilling at Signal Hill and experiencing like gorgeous sunset vibes, we like now drove back and we got to see like Table Mountain and all the lights and just the sea view from at night. Like, it was just gorgeous. But at this time, I was like done for the day. I didn't want to shoot any more content. I just wanted to be home and warm up. And hence now I'm taking another bath for the third time because I'm so tired. Like, I'm over today. I don't want to shoot anymore. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. Tomorrow's gonna be a fun day.